Hello, everybody. Welcome back to Assassin's Creed 2. I tried starting this a little bit ago, but basically, I'm going to have to edit the first, like, 5 minutes that I was recording together. My internet went out because it's been going out the last 2 days because it's a pile of fucking shit. So, in the last little 5 minutes, in between then and now, I basically just kind of like went and got the rest of these viewpoints. There's no other codex pages, so we can basically just go back to the objective that we need to, so that we can go talk to my sister. Because I wanted to grab all the codex pages before we went back to Florence, so that we could just get them all, you know, translated at once. I don't want to have to come back here and get them and then go back and then back and forth. Because I'm already going to have to come out here to get all the treasure and do, like, the races and stuff like that. So, hopefully my internet will fucking hold its shit together, I guess. It went out yesterday at, like, 6 or 6:30 as well for, like, a minute or so. Alright, so I can come back to Tuscany later to do all that shit. I'll probably actually just get all the feathers while I'm there as well. Because with Florence, we still have the third area to get, and I want to wait till I've gotten the entirety of it to start getting all the feathers. She's down here, never mind. That's right, because she is going to be the one we talk to about the money issue.
Salute, Claudia.
Our uncle is un mostro. This is outrageous.
What's happened?
He's making me work. If Father was here, I'd never be stuck behind a desk like this.
And what are the terms of this supposed enslavement?
Since someone decided we're going to stay here, Tio Mario suggested we try and find the money to repair the villa. Problem is, there isn't any.
I bet I can bring in some money.
Oh, great. More work for me. Well, benissimo. If you start paying for improvements to the town, I'll keep track of them in this book. And since I have nothing better to do, I'll also make note of any objects you bring in from the outside. If you actually get this place up and running, travelers might visit and spend money. Although I doubt anyone will want to come this far out of the city. But if they do, I'll keep the money we make in this chest. You're going to have to show up to take it to the bank yourself. Because when it gets full, I'm just going to take the extra cash for myself. Capito?
Deal.
Alright, so yeah. You can see here that from the... This is how much you get, basically. How much you're getting, like, per... like the value and how much you're earning per like 20 minutes. So for me, like what I like to do is I will just leave this game running in the background a lot of the time to like just get shit. But if you get the shops, all shops are open and all shops are level 3. Renovations to all these locations. Collections, so your feathers, your codex pages, the models, the seals, the paintings, portraits of your targets, and then the bonuses from those. Weapons, all of the armor, all of the, you know, different armors that you build up. Those will give you, you know, all of that. So the maximum chest capacity right now is 820. So I basically, when it fills up, I'll have to come and get that.
Buongiorno. Is there something wrong?
This is the guy that will help us rebuild stuff.
Deal with this mess.
But I'm an architetto, not a miracle worker. Without money, I can't fix any of these buildings.
And if someone brought you money?
Then we'd be in business. You must be Ser Ezio. Am I right?
Uncle, I like this architetto.
He gets very observant when he can smell money.
If you want to fix up this town, I'm going to need it. I have a price list here for new shops and renovations. Just bring me gold, make a choice, and I'll begin at once. If I build you a shop, you, as the landlord, can purchase goods there at lower rates. If you invest more money in the shop, you get an even greater discount. As for renovations, well, you'll be bringing the town and villa back to life. As Sir Mario tells me, that was very important to your great-great-grandfather. Plus, when you buy shops and renovations, you'll be increasing the number of people who visit, causing your income to increase. So, let's take a look, shall we?
All right, so we have the art merchant. Sells paintings. Go ahead and get him. The bank.
Buon viaggio.
Buon viaggio.
Buongiorno.
Salute, Ser Ezio. Shall we take a look at the list?
All right. So that blacksmith we already have. Doctor. Let's get the tailor.
Buon viaggio.
God damn it! Why does it keep backing out?
Buongiorno.
Salute, Ser Ezio. Shall we take a look at the list?
At 3,600. All right, so brothel, the mines, the church, the barracks, the thieves' guild, and the well. All right, well, we can go ahead and we'll do the mines. We'll do the brothel, excuse me. So this is just like a one-time thing.
Buon viaggio.
All right. So now the city's value.
Salute, Claudia.
You here to look at the book?
So now, as you can see, we're earning 1,279 florins every 20 minutes. Because of the shops renovated, all shops are open. We have a 5,000 increase. Renovations, we have the brothel. And yeah, so now the maximum chest capacity is 5,120. So basically, for me, what I like to do is I just like to leave this game running and I'll go like do something. Like I'll go watch a movie or, you know, whatever. And then basically every hour I will then like come and collect the chest and I'll just leave this game running. I used to, like, I'll just like leave the game running for like 3 or 4 or 5 hours just to collect money so I can then increase these more. So I'll probably end up doing that at some point as well.
Presto, Ezio.
So yeah, it's just something that I do.
Ezio, my boy, I think it's time I showed you something.
And now we're about to get to the real goods. Some of the most fun stuff in the game. Well, it's related to what we're about to see.
This is the sanctuary. It was built by my great-grandfather to honor the memory of the Assassin Order and protect its secrets. Look around. These are the assassins who guarded the freedom of humanity when it was most threatened. And this is the armor of Altair. Little is known about Altair's life, but his armor is light and very strong. I give it to you but I don't know how to retrieve it. My great-grandfather told me it would remain locked away until all its protectors were made whole. I heard rumors of crypts located throughout Italia. Hidden tombs filled with treasure, where these six were moved centuries ago. Maybe they have something to do with it. In my younger days, I sought the six myself, with no success. Perhaps you will have better luck.
Yeah, so these are some of the most fun. A couple of these are pretty frustrating.
Synchronization with Ezio, you have to get that armor.
So basically, the thing about the dungeons, the crypts, I guess you could say, some of them are kind of frustrating, but a lot of them are actually pretty fun. So you have Qualan Gall, the statue of Qualan Gall. The statue of Darius. The statue of Wei Yu. The statue of Amunet. The statue of Iltani. And the statue of Leonidas. So all of these, like, you know, assassins of history, basically you go and you do their crypt, and then you bring their medal back. And once you've done that, one of these will unlock. And this armor is the best armor in the game. So, again, like future games, there is, like, a really good armor that you'll get, and you have to do shit to get it. And this is the armor that, you know, we need to get by doing all of these crypts. Now, these crypts are all located in different maps throughout, you know, like, they're all located throughout the world. They're basically large puzzles. Some of them are fun. Some of them are frustrating. The big I would say that one of the most frustrating ones is the big church, which is in Florence. That one's pretty frustrating because of its climbing aspects. But there is a lot of, like, checkpoints in which you can drop ladders and stuff like that. So if you fall, you can climb back up. But they are some of the coolest parts of the game because they're, they're just interesting to do. So, yeah. So we have our tailor now. In terms of our pouches, we can still buy this. What do we have? Oh, it's all the same ones from the other. Right. Fair enough. Paintings. We have some paintings here. But I want to get this first. And we'll buy that.
Don't forget to send your friends.
Oh, this one's here. So yeah, I mean, it's really, really the best way to earn a lot of money in order to... The best way to earn a lot of money very quickly is basically to just invest in the city. Investing in the city by buying and renovating all the buildings early on will get you a lot of money so that you can just afford to basically buy... all of the weapons and all of that in the future. I gotta remember how to get up here. It's like the most slow mechanic, though, getting all the treasure. It's kind of obnoxious. Okay, here we go. I wanted to get this treasure over the gate. Because, yeah, I'll probably spend time getting all of the feathers in, like, all the Tuscany. If we get the... if we get the third location in Florence, I'll probably spend time, like, in between these parts doing a lot of that. just makes my life easier. All right, back to Florence. Gotta go see Leonardo. So it's now 1478. It's been 2 years. Wanted here. Let's go ahead and get rid of that. So you can see, like, it'll, you can go straight to Tuscany from here. You can go to Montagione. You can travel between, like, the different areas pretty easily, so you don't actually have to deal with all the bullshit. All right, so we have a viewpoint over here. Let me go ahead and grab that. We go talk to Leonardo.
Noble prices for noble wares. Armor fit for an emperor. And the price for that.
Because if we have any codex pages over here, I want to grab those before we talk to him as well. We also have three glyphs here as well. Probably start down here. Oh, there's one here. Oh, I actually remember this one. It's on the side of one of these. I actually remember finding this one. Here it is. I knew it was on the side of, like, one of the building parts.
Something was up there. Something abandoned long ago.
Apollo. All right, find the eagle. Okay, the moon. With these formidable weapons, the adversaries of freedom plan to consolidate their territory, to exploit, to control, and finally to destroy. Oh, that's right. We gotta line this up. I'm gonna restart this. What do I have to, like, fucking leave the area first or some shit? Like, what the fuck? Just let me do it again.
I have served dukes, princes, kings.
I've distilled an elixir of lead and pomegranate.
Does this something in, you know?
Something was up there.
Okay, there we go. Okay. So I feel like this one we need to turn first. I feel like that's...
Sure it is. Deep underground, it was easy.
All right, so that was the 10th one, I believe. See, like, this one, this map isn't so, like, vertical. It has a few, like, tall buildings, but, you know, like, they're not really the whole idea of the city. Whereas Tuscany, it's all just vertical. So it's all based around the verticality. With this, like, a lot of those tall buildings are like, the viewpoints.
What a skill!
How about you not talk about my mental health? Okay.
You're not allowed up here. Leave. Get down now.
Oh, that's Stephanie, I think. Oh, I do.
All right.
I just realized I need the treasure map for this area. Fucking, it's right there. Just grab it. Jesus Christ. It's so that's like one of the most aggravating thing about some of these older games is it's like the ledge is so easily accessible yet he will not climb. It doesn't make any sense. I should probably stop by this art merchant to buy the maps. Great, am I gonna have to walk in circles to find this fucking guy? Yep. So yeah, this is all the paintings for Florence. Here we go.
Thank you. We do come again.
Got that. Alright, let's get this viewpoint. I think...
You won't believe your
art! Break something, the idiot. Vide bene chi ride ultimo.
I really... need to see if there's... like, codex pages. I think there's got to be at least one or two. I don't need to climb that high. Ah, there we go, there's one. Let's grab this. It's on the other side of here. Anybody to hire around here?
Hey! What's going on? Don't expect me to get violent.
I forgot about the thieves.
Stay away from me.
What the fuck? That was bullshit.
I was going to get it back. Well, alright. No, not really, but... please don't kill me!
Paying the robber's money as well as my own. I didn't even know he took my money, to be honest. Is there nobody to fucking hire around here? Right, well... So those guards are a little harder than that one that I just killed. They're starting to kind of up the enemies. The heavy armor guards are such a fucking pain in the ass. Right, let's get that. Apologizing for. Alright, there's that. Let's see. I don't know if there's any more, but... probably just go get all these waypoints. Well, there we go. There's like $1,200 in the chest.
I've heard love makes men do the strangest things.
I always think that I'm climbing the rooftops because I'm going to sneak in some girl's window. Ah, there is a second one. I thought so. There's usually like one or two in every area. Okay, fucking 35,000 people are gonna join. Good, fuck off. See, that's the thing too, is that the longer the fights go on, the longer that the fights happen for, the more like wanted level you gain. So it doesn't necessarily matter how many people you fight, it really only matters how long you're fighting for. Specific types of enemies. Oh, another one here. A weekly bleeding is part of a family that I know. So it's on this building somewhere. Was that it? No, that's a feather, is it? Oh no, that's the feather. This is the, okay, this is the glyph. Okay.
He wanted to stop the cycle, to tell the secret. Shit! I've got to keep thinking. Ruin the headaches.
The Inventor. From Nikola Tesla. The economic transmission of power without wires is of all surpassing importance to man. By its means, he will gain complete mastery of the air, the sea, and the desert. It will enable him to dispense with the necessity of mining, pumping, transporting, and burning fuel, and so do away with the innumerable causes of sinful waste. It will make the living glorious sun his obedient toiling slave. It will bring peace and harmony on earth. Yeah, unfortunately it's not, because everybody, you know, is trying to say that electric cars are, like, bad. Because, you know, they use electricity and we can't support a power grid and stuff. But instead of investing in a better power grid, we just keep on burning fossil fuels. So, sorry, Tesla. Right. Nikola Tesla's Wardenclyffe Tower under construction, 1902. Right. That'd be here.
He found it in Croatia.
Oh, infrared. Oh, right here.
He found it in Croatia. They would find it.
Used to be number 4. I think there are like 6 apples of Eden. And all this is useless bullshit currently. You might have an idea from looking at this who these people are. Perhaps, maybe. Can I climb this window? Yes, I can. Oh, god damn it. I ran in that feather without thinking. How the shit do I get up here? There's nowhere to grab. Oh, I guess that'd be this here. No. How the fuck do I get this? Okay, I just reach up to it. I was like, there's no way to get up there. Okay, so that's all of the, in terms of my maps, it's all of the Florence and, oh, there are glyphs in the countryside for Tuscany. Oh, I did get those. Okay, so we got the one in Montagier. We got all the Tuscany ones. We got all the Florence ones. So we have the Roma and the Venice ones. So there's 3 districts with ones in Venice, and there's one in... There's like one district for Roma, for Rome. All right, cool. Okay, so we're headed back for Leonardo. Get all of these codex pages. Bro, don't even try it.
Can't catch me!
Must be leaving. Yes. Now, in fact, we must be you.
See you later, loser. Yeah, that's something that will happen every so often. You'll get thieves trying to rob you.
That month, Visconti bought 300 of my finest sabers.
It's pretty obnoxious.
Ezio, you are still alive.
Look at this place. The past 2 years have been kind to you.
But you are not the same at all, are you?
I was hoping you might be able to help me with something.
Anything for you, my friend. Ha ha! You found another one!
Another one? I found like 12.
This one is tricky to break. Clever in its use of ancient languages. Maybe if I just... Oh, it seems to be a manual of sorts for different assassination techniques.
May I see it?
Wait, what's that? It's not so much a design this time, just a series of sketches. What to make of all this? Of course, and why not? What an inspired idea.
Can you make it for me while I try what's in that manual fragment?
Take it. I'll have my assistant set up some dummies for you to practice with. Hey, Vincenzo!
Practice several new assassination techniques while he tinkers with the codex. So 12 deciphered. Told you, I brought like 12. Hidden blade upgraded. 2 health squares gained. Alright, so now we can do the assassination from the hiding spot. Ugh. So we have assassination from high up point, which is what I've been waiting for. Especially in relates to the guards standing in the doorways. There we go. And then the third one is assassinating somebody from below. Which is what I wanted to do to... What's-his-face, the castle, but... I forgot. I don't have all that shit.
I've done it. Come quickly. Look. Take it. Try it.
Thank you, Leonardo.
Non c'è di che.
There's someone I need to see while I'm here. I cannot approach him publicly. Would you know a way...
La Volpe.
The fox.
Shh.
Capisco. But do you know where a fox might roam?
Perhaps near the Mercato, where the thieves dwell. Sta attento, amico.
Thank you, Leonardo. So yeah, there we go. Couple health squares gained. All that good stuff. Alright. So we'll head... There's a race over there. Go ahead and rip this down.
Listen well! I also have overstock from...
So yeah, this will allow me to travel, by the way, to different locations if I want to, without having to, So yeah, my hidden blade has an armor plate now, so deflect weapon attacks. I also now have double the hidden blades, which is pretty nice. The double de-do.
Ragazzi of suitable age. The city guard is recruiting volunteers for the road patrols in city.
Yeah, this is why you find the codex pages. Fox hunt. Locate La Volpe somewhere near the Mercato Vecchio. Or Vecchio. Dumbass.
I really have no interest in hurting you. So give me back my money and we'll call it even.
Not so fast.
Hello, La Volpe.
Who are you? They call me many things. Murderer. Tagliagole. Thief. but you may call me La Volpe.
At your service, Messer Ezio.
How do you know my name?
It is my business to know everything in this city. Isn't that...
Does that Tia really never put all the pieces together?
To find someone. To know where he'll be before even he does.
Who?
Francesco de Pazzi.
There's word on the street of a caravan just arrived from Roma. A secret meeting at sunset tonight. You can learn something of Francesco's whereabouts there.
Do you know where it is to be held?
Ma certo. Let me know when you are ready, and we'll go. Ah, yes. Here is your money.
Cool. You say, there's a chest over here that I want to get. Real quick. Prosciutti! So yeah, so now you can see we have the dual hidden blades rather than just the one. Yeah, he does. You can do a double assassination, which is pretty sick. Sorry, La Volpe, I tried to tackle you there.
Follow me. But we must move fast. Think you can keep up?
Nessun problema.
See you there. So meet La Volpe at Santa Maria Novella. Dude, you waited.
We are. Francesco di Pazzi is meeting his people inside that church.
How do I join them?
There are catacombs that run.
See it, Rice? You see it twinkling down there.
It will lead you to a place where you can eavesdrop on the meeting. Grip that stone handle, turn it, then slide it down.
The first of our six.
Thank you for all your help, Volpe.
Buona fortuna.
All right, so here's the first of our six. Always love the little skull assassin logo for the for these. So yeah, these are easily like the coolest parts of the game, to be honest. Infiltrate Santa Maria Novella's catacombs to reach the Templar meeting. Oh, hello. Yeah, the camera basically shows you the path. Some of these have time puzzles as well. You would have thought that those guards would have been like, what the hell?
How long do we have to stand here, Saverio? It's so cold.
What do you want, Ilario? Messer Pazzi is paying us good money to watch the entrance, and the dead won't try to murder us. I can't wait to go home to Elena and tell her how much gold we made tonight.
Open the door. Hi.
Hey, that could be him.
Eccolo! No, you go.
Bye. Yeah, these tombs do have chests and everything in them as well. There was water there. All right, let's do it again. Or let's fucking not. So I like some of the later ones, they have checkpoints because you'll fall and I guess I shouldn't have just, like, jumped off the edge. I need to go here. Come on.
Merda! The door! Keep watch while I go look. This was supposed to be an easy job.
I told you we shouldn't have come here. If I hear anything, I'm running to the other guard post, so help me God.
Isn't there, like, an ability to whistle, or... Is there not the ability to whistle? I don't think it actually tells me. Oh, flying machine? No, normal. Thank you very much. So how am I supposed to assassinate him from here if he won't come over here? Because is there not... So yeah, you don't have the ability. How the fuck am I supposed to get him over here? Oh no, your friend is dead. There we go. Hi. Now we gotta chase after this guy.
Saverio! I'll be back with the other guards!
Yes. Yes. I think I got away.
He's not going to get me.
Yeah, you did! What? What's the point of having this if I can't actually... Thank you. Got ya. So basically, he would have ran to that door and closed it and signaled the other guards if I hadn't got him. Now they don't know I'm coming. Fun with that, guys.
Et benedictio Dei omnipotentes, Patris et Filii et Spiritus Sancti, descendat super vos et maneat semper.
Grazie, padre. Bernardo?
It's all here. Swords, staves, axes, armor, bows. Our men will want for nothing.
I take this gift to mean the Pope consents.
He gave his blessing to the operation. As long as nobody's killed.
We're all set for the Duomo in the morning, Signore. The bait's been laid, but it wasn't easy. His fool brother keeps changing his plans.
Si. We'll need to be on hand to make sure Giuliano even gets out of bed for church tomorrow.
What is it, Jacopo? Do you think they suspect something?
Impossible! The Medici are too arrogant or too stupid to even notice. Likely a bit of both.
Do not underestimate our enemies, Francesco. Or have you already forgotten how your son was murdered?
We'll suffer no such surprises this time, Maestro. You have my word.
Molto bene. I should be off. I've some other business to attend to before I return to Rome. Gentlemen, tomorrow a new sun rises over Firenze. May the Father of Understanding guide us.
May the Father of Understanding guide us.
All right, so open the sarcophagus.
Look at that statue.
A bunch of treasure here as well.
The Villa Auditore. I think you've stumbled onto one of the assassin's tombs Ezio's uncle mentioned.
Now that we know the way in, I'll tag the landmarks containing tombs in the database.
All right, there we go. Discover the assassin tomb under Santa Maria Novella. So all of those have achievements. Armor broken. Visit a blacksmith to repair it.
I know where Francesco will be and when, but...
What is it?
I overheard something. They have weapons, enough for a battalion. Even the Pope has given support.
Typical of Sixtus, but... What the hell are they planning?
I couldn't understand the specifics, but it involves the Medici, and it begins tomorrow morning at the Duomo.
The Medici will all be there for Sunday service. Along with the rest of Firenze.
They're going to do it right in the middle of High Mass.
But it's also a chance for me to blend with the crowd, get close, and stop this madness.
If they succeed, if we lose Lorenzo and Firenze falls to the Pazzi...
It will not come to that. I promise.
I hope you are right.
All right, yeah, so explore Assassin's Tombs, find the seals for the Villa Auditore. So yeah, the second one is here. So that's where I want to go. In all honesty. You stop by this blacksmith, though.
I apologize. Please let me remove it.
Pair. There's the rest of my leather. And we have the better greaves and spalders. They're all the same except for the maul. Oh, the stiletto knife. We have all of our throwing knives.
I suppose you only appear to be calm.
Alright, so let's go do that other assassin's tomb, shall we? So this is the church one that I was talking about earlier that's a little annoying. Nighty-night. Again, though, I still think that all of them are cool, regardless of them, like, regardless of how annoying they are or not. There's some of the better, it's like some of the better content for this. Like, I mean, that first one's not really that interesting. I think it's really because it's part of the story and kind of designed to be like, hey, guess what? You have a... Here's a tomb. Grab this on the way as well.
The citizens of Pisa have held a mass demonstration, once again sending Firenze a message of contempt. Unbelievable prices I have for you, stimati clienti.
All right, so... And the Assassin's Tomb icon. Here it is. Could you imagine seeing that on the side of a building going, what the fuck is that? So this one's basically a giant platforming puzzle. And it's so obnoxious. Especially if you fall.
Stay away from the artwork on the walls. And when your men paint the dome, take care not to disturb any of the sacred relics in the lanterna on top. They are the most important artifacts in our church.
Yes, yes, Padre. Just make sure to pay us the full sum for our work.
Dude, imagine getting paid, like, a shit-ass wage to paint on the inner rooftop of a big-ass dome church. You're getting paid, like, $4. Bro, fuck all that. Explore Basilica Santa Maria del Fiore and find the Assassin's Seal. Again, the camera does kind of give you the contextual clues of where to go. It does not make this one any less annoying. Alright, so... There we go, there's our ladder. It's our checkpoint.
Now I have a way back up in case I fall.
Let's go jump up to there. See, that's what I'm talking about. The again, like, the game's idea, right, is all this, like, free running. But it's still in this, it's still in this space in which it's so basic and clunky. And it feels like, it feels omnidirectional. It feels directional based, where it's like, oh, you're not perfectly facing for like the thing in front of you. Well, guess what? You're not jumping to it. Like, sometimes it feels like there's leeway, but then there's other times where it feels like it's actively working against you. See, sometimes you feel like you're pulled towards the object. Alright, there we go. Second checkpoint. So, go to that, and then we got to go over here. I feel like I just remember how to do all this. I mean, it's not really that difficult. It's just... it really is just, like, the controls that hold you back. Like, they feel a little smoother in, like, the remastered versions, but even with that being said, it's still not as, like, refined as it becomes. I feel like that's one of the issues of with people who never played these when they were younger. Like, when I was, obviously, like, when I was a kid, well, I wouldn't say a kid, but when I was younger, when I was in my teens playing these, basically, for me, it's like, this was the only thing we had. So, we didn't have, you know, like, Valhalla and shit like that. There's gotta be... Okay, yeah, I can get up there. It is kind of funny to always see people who were used to playing, you know, the newer games... Probably from, like, Origins on, and they never played any of the previous ones, to go back and play, like, this one, for example. Or even, like, one, and see how bad the controls are. Alright, now we're getting to the shit of it. We fall here, we're fucked. I've had my share. I've had my share of falling from all the way up here. I've even fallen from here. There was one time I was not, like, it was probably one of the first times I played. I was not expecting the camera to change, and when I came up here, I just, like, walked off. Like, I like, walked to this, and I, like, ran over the edge, and I dropped all the way below, and I nearly threw my head into a wall. It was so aggravating. Again, this one I only find to be annoying because it's like a platformer, and if you are not really paying attention, close attention to where you're moving, you will fall, and you'll break your armor, and you'll die, and you have to start the whole damn thing over. All right, there we go. Choir boy! Oh god, oh god, oh god! See, like that. That's exactly what fucking happens. That's exactly what happens inside there. Good job of not grabbing anything, you fucking moron. Well, at least I don't have to deal with my armor being broken. Alright, now that we have access to those... where is... Fast travel. I want to go to the other locations. I don't remember where all of these are. I know they show up, but I don't remember if there's any of these in the other locations.
I have to steal that elixir of lead and pomegranate.
All right, so let's go to San... you know what? Let's just go Southgate. Fuck it. But yeah, I don't remember if there's any more of these. There might be one in Tuscany? I just don't remember. There might be even one in Montorgioni, or not. I'm just going to call it Super Mario World. All right, so there's one here. It's the one that we need to do anyway.
Please, amigo, stop this. I mean you no harm.
Yeah. Rip that off there.
Where do you think you are?
There may be one bed left at the Dungeon Inn. No, really. It has its advantages. It's inexpensive. Go. And don't be an idiot.
Shut up. Do I want to just go through here? It's treasure. Along the way. Okay, let's see. I actually, in all honesty, don't even remember this one. I don't even remember what this one is. Oh yeah, and the only other thing you get for getting all the feathers as well is a little cutscene with Mom. Oh, that's right. It's this one. Yes. This is the swimming one. I gotta get up here, but I don't remember. I don't remember how. I think I have to, yes, climb along the wall. Here we go. Oh no, this isn't the water one. That one's another one. Never mind. There's like a creature in the water. That's not this one. I kind of remember this one now.
That cloak. A statue, my man.
Something about that cloak. So familiar.
You there, stop.
Messeri, aspetta un momento.
Hold a moment, Messeri.
Hey, cittadino!
You there, stop!
B.
Like you!
Be quiet. Thank you. Alright, so... Alright, so let's figure out how to get up here. We're just following this path this way. This ledge. Neither will you. Bye-bye. Oh god, yeah, see the heavy guards. What the hell? Prepared to fight this guy.
Make room for the guard. Mounted on a pike.
Oh shit. I lost him.
Another one. With a murderer loose. Did anyone see what happened?
That was perfect.
Hey, that could be him.
Like you, not so fast. Bye. I just gotta avoid the heavy. Yeah, so this is the climb everything and avoid or kill the guards tomb.
Eccolo, you won't escape.
What did you hope to accomplish from that? You should have just kept your mouth closed and mind your business. No. Here we go. Guard stuck right there? That is. I really just gave that guy the sauce. Fucked him up. He was stuck in the wall. He paid for it. And there we are. Make sure we grab all these chests. Some of them do have other chests that are along the way, but without a map, you can't really see them. The way you seal. I can see your house from here. And we have a good amount of money sitting in the chest as well. We're gonna head back to the villa. There might be a tomb there, but the other ones might be in Venice. The other three. I don't think there's one in Rome, because that's like the end of the game. Oh, 'tis a joy you've stuck me up here. Whee! Alright. No, fuck off. Fast travel? I'll have to leave the city.
Truly, I am blessed this day. Two new artists.
All right, so I have those paintings. What? I bought those.
No matter. Yeah. Have a good day, sir.
I'll end up waiting until I have, like, I'm earning. Because you'll be able to earn like 20 or 30,000 every 20 minutes. That's when I'll start buying those paintings. Is once we get, like, once it's at, you know what we should do? We should also do this courier so we can read the letter. Hello, good sir.
Just delivered right away. If you're quick, I'll make it worth your while.
Chapel on the other side of town before the wedding ceremony begins. So it's a letter from Raimondo. Dear Vincenti? I have received evidence to prove our worst suspicions. Your daughter is marrying an imposter. Although Leon claims to be a Guelph, he is, in fact, Florentine. This is further proof that those liars and cheats are trying to invade our government and further take away your little independence we have. If upon reading this your blood is boiling as much as mine, I say we drop him off at the Torre Grossa, that will send a message to Florence. Yours, Raimondo. P.S. Once you have disposed of this annoyance, my son is of eligible age, as you know. Perhaps your daughter's hand would be better suited for his. Oh my god. How dare! That man was not a Guelph. He's a Florentine. Damn, that guy's a bit... Speaking of Florentine, that guy needs to lay off the chicken Florentine, if you know what I mean. Brother. I'm going to have to... I'm doing a bit of a climb here. I'm almost there anyway, so... Woo! Is that it? Wedding bells are ringing. Alright, oh, there's one closer out here. I don't need to do the race. I don't need to do the race. On stream. It's not like it's giving me, like, a letter or anything like that for us to read. Are you fucking serious? What's the point of this? What did you just call me? Due to the recent outbreak of choleric tumors found among Cavalli, the council requires regular inspection. What the fuck did that guy call me? Alright, so now we'll go to the villa. And fast travel is, like, so cheap that you don't have to, like, worry about spending all of your money. It's $4 for me to go here. Alright, so there is one here. Alright, so then that means the other two are in Venice. I think we have enough time to finish this last one. Pretty much just going all out on the Assassin's Tombs. Then once we complete this tomb, we'll take all of these emblems. Back inside, we'll get all of our money, we'll upgrade the villa a little bit. Just wanted to creak. Alright, what is this one? I'm trying to remember what this one is. This might be one of the ones that's timed. Venice, 1296. I was raised in a small house by the Venetian lagoon, within sight of the rough foam-capped waves of the sea. When I was barely old enough to walk, I became a sailor, navigating the Atlantic, first as an apprentice and then while carrying cargo. For my father's patron, Messier Marco Polo, it was a good life. Marco!
Hello.
Yeah. So I gotta run up this wall. There we go. Sure. One day, while ashore in the harbor looking for work, I fell in love. She was barely 20, but when I looked into her eyes, the whole world was reflected back, clearer and brighter than the sun. After that, I still went to sea, but my heart remained on land with the girl who had become my wife and our young son. Birthright. One afternoon that summer, Messier Polo called me into his study. My father was already there, beside an older man, dressed in a strange hooded cape, watching us. At that moment, everything about my life changed. My father told me that he was an assassin. Removing his ring, he showed me a strange marking on his finger. He explained that our family came from an ancient order that protected and defended mankind. He paused, and then, when I didn't speak, Messier Polo stepped forward. He told me that the stranger in the hood would teach me, and in return, I would carry him across the Mediterranean to Spain. And so began my apprenticeship with Dante Alighieri, one that was set to destroy every bit of happiness I would ever have. Yeah, see, even Dante, remember when we played Dante's Inferno? Even he was an assassin, see? And then he died and, like, went to hell. So yeah, this is a timed. A mentor. In preparation for our voyage, Messer Alighieri met with me repeatedly. At first, our meetings were about purchasing supplies, but soon they became about higher things. About life, love, honor, and justice. He taught me that society was set up in such a way as to control its members, to stop us from thinking, from seeing. Soon, I could look past all the laws and illusions. I understood that mankind was being used by its rulers, that we, the people, deserve freedom. It was then that Dante began showing me pages from a book that Messer Polo had brought back from the palace of the great Genghis Khan. The manuscript, the codex, was about our order, the assassins. Son of a bitch. Come on. Fucking just use it. Why do I gotta be looking directly at the fucking handle? To go down. Oh, there we go. Just reset it. There was that treasure over there, by the way, but I really didn't feel like having to redo that. Again, sometimes the camera works against you. An unexpected farewell. Our planned voyage never took place. While returning to Ravenna to pick up the remainder of my belongings, Dante died. Dismayed at the loss of my mentor, I went to inform my father and Messer Polo of the sad news. Before I could even speak, I was ushered into the study, and my father, while his face white, locked the door behind me. Shocked, I listened in silence as he spoke. Dante intended to take the Codex to Spain, where it would be safe. But while he watched, the enemy of the assassins, the Knights Templar, still existed. I recalled the stories he had told me of the Templars, and it became clear. Dante had been murdered. The Templars knew about the Codex, and they knew about us. Shaking, my father told me to take the Codex and leave for Spain at once with my wife and child. See? Told you he was murdered, see? Assassin's Creed and Dante's Inferno. Hand in hand. As Messer Polo ushered me out the door, he handed me a small piece of paper with a number on it. With this number, I could draw on his credit. more ducats than I had ever seen in my life at any bank in Italy. Guess this is a place that if I fall, this is where I can come back to here. And use that medicine. I always, like, reset it so that I don't have to deal with a, like, video taking away time. The video does take away time. Here we are. At sea. We set sail that night, the ship filled with cargo to sell in the markets at Barcelona. At first, all was well. Then, to avoid a coming storm, we laid anchor in the Ontario Harbor. Otranto Harbor, sorry. Cloaked in darkness, the pirates came. I didn't see them until they were already boarding my ship. I hid with my family in the hold, pulling out the codex. I ran the worn leather cover through my hands, then I broke the spine. The pages slid silently onto the floor. I scattered them into the chests, boxes, and containers I was carrying to market. The men who found us were drunk. I could smell it on their breath. When they asked for the codex, I knew who had sent them. Holding back my rage, I said that I had thrown it overboard. They started to laugh. Two men held me down, still grinning, while the rest cut off my wife's clothes. She begged for mercy until her voice gave out. Once they were done, they threw her into the sea. They took my cargo and sunk my ship and left me adrift, clinging to a piece of railing. I made it to the beach with my son. My wife's body washed up on shore the next morning with the tide. That allows you to, like, go back. Is this, like... It's like a little ledge up here. Possible for me to... Yes. As I say, that's probably what's up here.
500F.
I think this is the last one, I think. It's for all the marbles! Straight banger! One try. A new name. I never saw the sea again. Making my way to Florence, I rented a small room and then visited the bank. I had memorized Polo's account number. With the vast sum I now had at my disposal, I went to Venice in disguise to find my father. I returned to Florence the next day. Both Polo and my father were already dead. From that moment forward, I collected treatises on architecture, studied the classics, and took vocal lessons. I adopted the name Auditore, impersonating a noble in the Florentine court. Accepted as one of their own, I took on the trappings of nobility and constructed this villa for me and my son. And then I hunted them. I raised my son to fight, to find the Codex, and to kill Templars. Together, we would regain the honor of my wife and avenge the death of my father, two deaths that could never be repaid. To the auditory that reads this, remember that you are not a nobleman. You are not one of the deceivers. You are one of the people. Avenge us.
Mm.
Yeah, there we go. Two like tombs here. All right, so I didn't get a symbol thing for that. I just got money. All right, so I guess the other three are in Venice then. Maybe there is one room. I don't remember. Anyway, it's a crypt. All the way out back. Great. Cool. I've always kind of found it funny that when Ezio runs, he kind of like, his hands kind of like push as if he's swimming through water. It's the strangest look. It's like the strangest like running animation. It looks like he's like pressing his hands backwards like he's swimming. But he's not swimming, he's just running. It's really weird. All right, let's go ahead and buy some medicine.
You should feel better now, but
you should shut up. Let's see. Well, this one's pretty cheap. So that one. All right. I have that. Let's repair my armor.
I'll just count it again.
Alright, so there we are. So now we brought all those codex pages back. So yeah, we basically have to move this around. We'll read all of these pages when we have all of them. So you can like rotate these. So, yeah, like, for example, some of them don't have, they just have, like, pictures. Not many text. Templars versus Assassins. But yeah, we'll look at all of these once we have all of them. We'll, like, read through them and all that. So, we have 19 of 30, so we're, you know, we're pretty close to having the majority of them. We're almost two-thirds of the way there. Let's go ahead and stick. I don't remember who I have. Thank you. And we have the... It was this one, correct? Yeah. There we go. Alright, now let's go stick the feather that we have in the box. So that's probably something I'll be doing in between. The next part is I'll be going and getting all the feathers here and in like the main part of Tuscany. I'll be going and getting all of them there, at least those areas, and all the treasure as well. Oh yeah, let's get the money. There we go. We have 23,000, so we can actually have something to play around with here.
Salute, Sir Ezio.
Shall we take a look at the list? All right, so brothel. Let's do the mines. I always like to restore all these first. We'll restore the church. Barracks. Thieves Guild and the well. Alright, so we have all of these restored. Taylor, what do I want the blacksmith the most, but yeah, let's do this. Well, art merchant would be pretty good too. Yeah, let's just do the art merchant for the 5,000. All right.
Buon viaggio.
So now our value is skyrocketed, as you can clearly see. And if we talk to Claudia,
you're here to read the book.
All right. So now we're getting 4,584 florins every 20 minutes, with the chest holding 18,338. Total. So yeah, all the renovations are completed. So in terms of collections, my feathers will definitely be going up. And if I save money, I'll probably end up buying more of the renovations in between. Well, for the shops anyway, the renovations to the shops. So basically, I will get all of the renovations to this done. I will have both the shops at level 3 and all the renovations done before I start buying more paintings. Then I typically will go and get all of the paintings, you know, get a lot of like the feathers and stuff. The armor is good to have as well, and all of like the weapons collected as well. But the weapons, they don't take it up that much. So yeah. It's going to just be a lot of that, so. So yeah. We'll be raking in money pretty hand over fist, like I said earlier, pretty quickly. So in between now and the next part, I'll probably end up getting all of the treasures and feathers in both this and in Tuscany, as well as at least all of the treasures in the other part of Florence. I'm going to try to work on all of that stuff in between the next two parts. So we may have a little bit more of... I've only put out one part of Vanquish. I may end up like finishing Vanquish before we come back to this. Just because I want to get all that stuff done as a perfectionist and everything. So... but yeah, I hope that you enjoyed this. I will see you all in the next one. Take care and goodbye.